Not Like Us, an Ilse Beck FBI suspense thriller, Book 1. Written by Ava Strong. Narrated by Elaine Wise. Chapter 1. Her thumb wavered above the tarmac, the tips of her sneakers brushing the white line painted on the edge of the meandering highway. Sarah Beth frowned beneath the night as another car swished by, kicking up dust and prompting a crackling flurry of leaves against the concrete barrier behind her. She muttered darkly, keeping her hand up in the night, but raising a different finger now in the direction of the speeding sedan. Once the car was out of sight, she lowered her hand, shivering where she stood on the side of the road, just outside Seattle. The surroundings of the city were normally bathed in mist, even during the day, but now, under the cover of darkness and cloud, the only illumination came from the highway lights spread at 50-foot intervals and the occasional headlights of passing vehicles, though those were rare enough too. Sarah Beth shifted one shoulder, feeling a crick in her neck and wincing, rubbing at her upper arm and lowering her backpack to the ground. 15 cars now. 15 cars had ignored her. She sighed. The average was 22. She'd taken to counting ever since she'd fled the group home 4 years ago. They'd said she'd get herself hurt trying to live on her own. They'd said she wouldn't make it a week. Well, now, 4 years later, having turned 21 last month, she'd proven them all wrong. A life on the move, on the road, in boxcars or beneath underpasses, using gym showers or working for room and board, wasn't most people's version of the American dream. But Sarah Beth was free, more free than anyone she knew. A few uncomfortable nights sleeping in a Walmart parking lot or tidying up in a Planet Fitness bathroom was a small price to pay for freedom. When it came to such things, though, it was always a bit of a balancing act. How much makeup to wear, how clean to look. On one hand, if she was too groomed and prettied up, often the entirely wrong sorts would stop to give her a ride, though she had a gut feeling for these types of men. On the other hand, if she abandoned grooming standards entirely, then no one would want her in their car. Sarah Beth reached up and brushed her curly brown hair back behind her ears while practicing her smile. She'd been told more than once that she had a very pretty smile. She glanced back down the highway, her shoulder still aching, a soft chill falling over her. She shuffled a bit on the side of the road, her left leg prompting a wince as she readjusted her weight and half limped into a more comfortable standing position. She saw the truck before she heard it. First, bright headlights, too far off the ground to come from a sedan. A second later, as the truck dipped over the road, the lights lowering, she spotted the large blue cab and the flatbed behind it. Hastily, she brushed her hair back again, this time risking a full-toothed smile, like someone in the theatre, overacting for the sake of the audience in the back of the room, and jutted her thumb up. She leaned in just a bit, toeing the white line now and staring into the glare of the approaching headlights. Her stomach twisted and her smile began to flicker as the truck showed no signs of slowing down. On it came, faster, faster. Then, a screech of brakes. The lights dimmed and the large vehicle came to a jarring stop, only a few paces ahead of Sarah Beth. She swallowed, staring at where the vehicle had gone still. A hand waved through the open window, gesturing at her. No sound, no words, just a single flick of the wrist. Sarah Beth leaned forward, peering up at the face in the cab.
"You going to Seattle?" she called out.
Again, no audible response, just a quick flash of a thumbs up and another gesture of a beckoning hand like a flapping bird beneath the glow of the moon. Sarah Beth hesitated, staring up at the truck and swallowing. A second later, the flapping hand disappeared back into the truck, and then a single yellow post-it note fluttered to the ground, tossed from the window. Sarah Beth frowned even deeper now. She leaned down hesitantly, eyes firmly on the truck, but fingers scrambling for the note. She hadn't heard any scribbling, and in fact, the letters on the note were written in pen, as if perhaps the note had been written before. Was the driver mute?
Sarah Beth held up the note.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.